Mad Dog Vachon was so anxious to try and get to either Joe or Paul LeDuc that he went without the services of his brother, the imported Dale Lewis, who certainly needs no introduction to wrestling fans throughout the United States. A very, very rugged, defensive wrestler, extremely competent. I think he felt that he had the size going against Joe LeDuc while he would try and concentrate on Paul LeDuc. So we're going to see what happens now when Mad Dog Vachon and Dale Lewis take on Joe and Paul LeDuc.
Joe and Paul LeDuc, the Florida Tag Team Champions, are going against Mad Dog Vachon and Dale Lewis. Here you have two men formerly in the Olympics, both Mad Dog Vachon and Dale Lewis. Lewis competed twice. Lewis moves out. Very, very powerful wrestler. Perhaps a more even match for Joe LeDuc. You see LeDuc now taking all the pressure that Dale Lewis can exert at this time. Leverage against him, but look at those tremendously powerful arms now. Lewis, who had the advantage momentarily, now being driven slowly to the canvas by Joe LeDuc. Great display of strength and power here. Paul LeDuc watching on. Now, Mad Dog Vachon, who has a vendetta against the LeDucs anyway, double-teaming with Dale Lewis against Joe LeDuc. LeDuc trying to make it over to that far side. And LeDuc is mad. LeDuc is mad. 280 pounds of fighting fury, and Vachon backing away. And he backs a little bit too far. He's caught by Paul LeDuc. And now the LeDucs do some double teaming of their own. Dale Lewis moving in to interfere. Caught by them. Dale Lewis on the canvas, in trouble. Paul LeDuc caught by Mad Dog Vachon. As he went for the Boston Crab, broken up again. Caught by LeDuc and again broken up. Joe and Paul LeDuc, some great teamwork. Tag is made, Joe LeDuc moves back into the ring. This man's a real bear. Joe LeDuc, the booming right hand, the drop. Dale Lewis. Lewis on the canvas. Mad Dog Vachon attempting to move in from behind, stopped by the referee. Joe LeDuc with a side headlock now. Dale Lewis trying to break out of it if he can. And as he tried to break free, it was Joe LeDuc hanging in there. Referee checking again. Mad Dog Vachon into the ring, and big Joe LeDuc after him. Vachon, extremely tricky, a very deceptive wrestler, caught in the midsection. And that time, hurtled into the far ring post. Again, Joe LeDuc moves in, puts the bear hug on Mad Dog Vachon into those ring ropes. Joe LeDuc bringing him away. As they do, he rips across the eyes. Takedown by Joe LeDuc. As Vachon now in a head scissors. Vachon gets that foot outside the ring. Joe LeDuc, good clean break. Tags up with his partner Paul, his brother Paul. And now Paul LeDuc goes for the head scissors, and Dale Lewis moves into the ring, blocked by the referee, and here comes Joe LeDuc, reaching across, trying to get at Dale Lewis. And this gives Dale Lewis an opportunity. He puts the sleeper hold on Paul LeDuc. He has the sleeper on Paul LeDuc. LeDuc is out. Mad Dog Vachon on his feet. And Joe LeDuc, realizing the injustice, has moved against them. Joe LeDuc complaining about what has occurred. Of course, the referee could not see it happen. Joe LeDuc as Dale Lewis up in that one-arm backbreaker. Now he catches Mad Dog Vachon as he moves off the ropes. Paul LeDuc still out on the canvas. And Joe LeDuc wants both the Dale Lewis and Mad Dog Vachon. Vachon in with a cross body ride. A count of three, but indicated here, of course, that Mad Dog Vachon and Dale Lewis have won this match. Obviously under protest, and now Dale Lewis reviving Paul LeDuc, but Joe LeDuc pounding away at Mad Dog Vachon, and the referee had been informed finally that the sleeper hold had been used on Paul LeDuc, and that Dale Lewis had come in from outside of the ring. And so the winners end by reverse decision are the LeDuc brothers, Joe and Paul LeDuc, winning by a reverse decision.